Today I am going to give you a lecture on eigenvalue. This is my lecture number 8 in which we discuss the eigenvalues. Before we start eigenvalues, I would like to give you a brief intro about the characteristic matrix, the characteristic polynomial, and then we come to a characteristic equation. And finally, we discuss the eigenvalues. And then trace of matrix, transpose of matrix, which we use in the property of eigenvalues. And finally, we discuss the problem related to eigenvalues. Now, first of all, we start with characteristic matrix. For any given square matrix, let us suppose our square matrix is A, capital A stands for square matrix. The matrix A minus lambda I, which is a subtraction of two matrices, where A is any given square matrix, and according to the order of A, we decide the unit matrix, that is our identity matrix I, which we usually denote by capital I. For any given square matrix A, matrix A minus lambda I, which is the subtraction of two same order matrix A minus lambda I, is called the characteristic matrix, and where lambda is some scalar quantity. And this capital I stands for unit matrix. So let us consider a square matrix A, which is of 3 into 3 order, which possesses 3 number of rows and 3 number of columns. And for the same order, we consider a unit matrix I, which is again 3 into 3 order, so whose principal diagonal elements are 1, 1, 1, and remaining all entries are 0. In order to obtain characteristic matrix for any given square matrix, first of all, we multiply our unit matrix with scalar quantity lambda. Here we have A minus lambda I. A is our given square matrix. Instead of I, we write 3 into 3 unit matrix, and we multiply this unit matrix with scalar quantity lambda. And as soon as we multiply or introduce lambda inside the matrix, so wherever we have 1, 1, 1, it's replaced by lambda, because lambda into 1, lambda into 1, lambda into 1 becomes lambda. And finally, we subtract these two matrices, matrix A and the matrix lambda I, which gives us a resultant matrix. And you know how to subtract two matrices. We just subtract the corresponding element in the both the matrices. So finally, we get 2 minus lambda, which is difference of 2 and lambda. And 2 minus 0 gives us 2, 1 minus 0 gives us 1. And similarly, rest of the element we calculate. And this resultant matrix is basically our characteristic matrix for a given square matrix A. So in this manner, we calculate our characteristic matrix. Here we consider the case of 3 into 3. We may use a square matrix of 2 into 2 order also. And for the 2 into 2 square matrix A, we consider again a unit matrix, and which is again same order, 2 into 2, which is I2, and the unit matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. This we consider for any square matrix A of 2 into 2 order. Let us consider, for example, we have 3, 5 and 1, 6. This is 2 into 2 square matrix, and for this 2 into 2 square matrix, we consider our unit matrix of same order, 2 into 2, which is 1, 0, 0, 1. And further, we multiply this unit matrix with a scalar quantity lambda, which gives us lambda 0 and 0 lambda. And finally, in order to obtain characteristic matrix for square matrix A, we subtract lambda I from this initially given square matrix A. So we write 3, 5, 1, 6 for A, and for lambda I we have lambda 0 and 0 lambda. Right? Now we subtract the corresponding elements. So 3 minus lambda, 5 minus 0 gives us 5, 1 minus 0 gives us 1, and 6 minus lambda. This resultant matrix is again 2 into 2 order, which possesses 2, number of rows are 2 and number of columns are again 2. So this is again 2 into 2 order characteristic matrix of a given square matrix A, which is of 2 into 2 order. So according to the order of A given square matrix, we consider our unit matrix and we multiply our unit matrix with a scalar quantity lambda. And finally we subtract this lambda I new matrix, which we obtain by just multiplying lambda with the unit matrix from a given square matrix. And this resultant matrix is known as characteristic matrix of a given square matrix A. Now we come to the definition of characteristic polynomial. See, characteristic polynomial is nothing, it's just a determined value of our characteristic matrix. Previously we discussed A minus lambda I, which is our desired characteristic matrix for a given square matrix A, that is A minus lambda. Instead of square bracket, here we use two vertical lines which represent the determined value of our characteristic matrix. And this characteristic matrix, when we replace this square bracket by our two vertical lines which represent the determined value of our characteristic matrix, and which is basically a cubic equation here in this case, because our square matrix is of order 3 into 3, so we get characteristic polynomial of 3 order. This lambda cube equations equation in terms of lambda having a degree 3. So the determinant A minus lambda I when expanded will give a polynomial, and which we call as the characteristic polynomial of a matrix A. And for example, same matrix we choose here, A matrix, and we construct a characteristic matrix for a given square matrix A, and which is 2 minus lambda 1, 1, 2, 3 minus lambda 2, 1, 1 and 2 minus lambda. This is our characteristic matrix. And now we just determine the determinant value of this characteristic matrix, and after expanding this we will get the desired cubic equation in terms of lambda, and which is our desired characteristic polynomial. See how we expand this determinant 2 minus lambda 2 1 1 3 minus lambda 1 1 2 and 2 minus lambda. We expand this determinant using a 2 minus lambda and find the, we just hide the first row and first column and just cross multiply 3 minus lambda with 2 minus lambda and cross product of 2 and 1, and we put negative sign between them. Further we took a negative value for 2 and again we cross multiply, hide the second column and first row, and cross multiply 2 minus lambda 1 into 1, and the final entry is plus 1. For this we hide the third column and first row, so our product is simply 2 into 1 which is 2 and 3 minus lambda into 1. So in this manner we expand our determinant and find the ultimate cubic equation by just multiplying this 3 minus lambda with 2 minus lambda, 3 to the 6, minus 3 lambda, minus of 2 lambda, minus lambda gives us lambda square. Finally, 2 minus 1 gives us 1, minus lambda, plus 1, this gives us minus 1 plus lambda. And after simplification we get lambda square, minus 2 and minus 3 lambda gives us minus of 5 lambda, plus 6, plus 6 and minus of 2 gives us plus 4, minus 2 and plus 2 lambda, this is minus 1 plus lambda, and we determine the product of these two factors, 2 lambda square minus 10 lambda plus 8 minus of lambda cube plus of 5 lambda square and minus of 4 lambda. And finally we get minus of lambda cube. 5 lambda square plus 2 lambda cube square gives us 7 lambda square. 10 and 4, 14. This 10 and 4, 14. We subtract 3 from the 14. So finally we get minus of 11 lambda. And 8 minus 2 and minus 1, so plus 5. So this is our desired characteristic polynomial, which we obtained by expanding this determinant of 3 to 3 order. And this is our characteristic polynomial for a given square matrix A. So in order to obtain a characteristic polynomial, we simply find the determinant value of this A minus lambda I, and we expand and give it the polynomial which we call as a characteristic polynomial of square matrix A, and which gives us minus of lambda cube plus 7 lambda square minus 11 lambda plus 5. The next definition is characteristic equation. So the equation determinant A minus lambda I, which is our characteristic polynomial, as soon as we put this characteristic polynomial is equal to 0, it gives us our desired characteristic equation. So determinant of A minus lambda I, which we already calculated, lambda minus of lambda cube minus 7 lambda square plus 11 lambda minus 5 is equal to 0. So in order to obtain a characteristic equation, we simply put our characteristic polynomial is equal to 0. This gives us a characteristic equation. And finally, we come to the definition of eigenvalues. See, the roots of the characteristic equation which we get previously are known as either characteristic roots or sometimes it is known as eigenvalues. So eigenvalues are nothing, it's just the roots of our characteristic equation. Here we consider our characteristic equation which we obtained in the previous slide, lambda cube minus 7 lambda squared plus 11 lambda minus 5 equal to 0, which is the characteristic equation for given square matrix A. After finding its roots, because the cubic equation in terms of lambda, so definitely it possesses three roots. And how we determine its three roots? Lambda cube minus 7 lambda square plus 11 lambda minus 5 equal to 0. This is cubic equation in terms of lambda, so it always possesses the three values of lambda. In order to obtain all three values of lambda, first we find one root by Hilbert-Weil method. Suppose we replace or substitute for lambda equal to 1. So we will find 1 cubed minus 7 into 1 square plus 11 into 1 minus 5. Definitely it is equal to 0 because 11 plus 1 is 12 and 7 and 5 again is 12. So as lambda equal to 1 satisfies this cubic polynomial, so definitely there exists a one real root and which is lambda equal to 1. So if lambda equal to 1 is one of the root of this cubic polynomial, then definitely lambda minus 1 is one of the factor of this cubic expression. In order to find the remaining quadratic expression, we just divide this cubic polynomial in terms of lambda with one of the linear factor which we already get, lambda minus 1. So we just divide this lambda cube minus 7 lambda square plus 11 lambda minus 5 with lambda minus 1. So initially we have lambda square. When we multiply lambda square with lambda, it gives us lambda cube minus lambda square. And after simplification, we'll observe 6 lambda square plus 11 lambda. Again, we choose minus of 6 lambda, which again gives us minus of 6 lambda square plus 6 lambda. And finally, we simplify the expression and we'll obtain 5 lambda minus of 5. And finally, we choose plus 5, because when we multiply 5 with lambda minus 1, it gives us again 5 lambda minus 5. And finally we determine our quadratic expression. So we determine two different factors for this cubic polynomial, which is lambda minus 1, and the remaining quadratic factor is lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 5. So in this manner we factorize our this cubic polynomial in terms of lambda into one linear factor and the remaining is quadratic factor. Further we apply factorization method, or we may apply Sridharacharya rule in order to obtain two different values of lambda from this quadratic expression, or factorize this quadratic equation into a two linear factor. So lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 5 equal to 0. And we factorize it because 5 was a 5, so we choose 5 minus 5 lambda minus lambda plus 5 equal to 0. Then we add them, minus 5 lambda and then minus lambda gives us again minus of 6 lambda. So we choose lambda as a common, so lambda minus 5. Then we choose minus 1 as a common, again we find lambda minus 5. And finally lambda minus 5 we choose as a common factor, and remaining is lambda minus 1. So from this quadratic factor lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 5, again we get two linear factors. One is lambda minus 1, the other one is lambda minus 1. So finally, for this cubic polynomial in terms of lambda, we get three roots, lambda, three factors, lambda minus 1, lambda minus 1, and lambda minus 5. Are three linear factors of this cubic equation. And if we determine the values of lambda from this expression, we will find 1, 1 and 5. And these are the three desired eigenvalues of our square matrix A. And here we observe that all first two values are identical, same. So these are the two repeated eigenvalues of our given square matrix A. And 5 is the distinct eigenvalue for the given square matrix A. So in this manner, we determine our eigenvalues for any given square matrix. So first of all, we start with the construction of characteristic matrix for any given square matrix. Further, we find our characteristic polynomial. And for characteristic polynomial, we simply find the determined value of our characteristic equation. And which, after expansion or expanding the this determined value of characteristic matrix, we get the equation in terms of lambda, and which is the desired characteristic equation. And finally, we determine the roots of characteristic equation, and these roots of characteristic equation is called our eigenvalues. So in this manner, we find our eigenvalues. Now we come to the trace of matrix. It is quite simple to find the trace of any matrix, because it is just a simply addition of principal diagonal element. Like the sum of principal diagonal elements of any square matrix, for any given square matrix, you simply add the principal diagonal element. And you know which is a principal diagonal? This diagonal is called principal diagonal, while this is other diagonal. So in order to determine trace of any given square matrix, we simply add the principal diagonal elements. So in this case, we have 3 into 3 square matrix A, and which possesses 3 elements in its principal diagonal, 2, 3 and 2. So we simply add them in order to find trace of this square matrix A. 2 plus 3 plus 2, which gives us 7. So the 7 is the desired trace of this given square matrix A. The next definition is transpose of any square matrix, or any matrix, it may be a non-square matrix. So for a transpose of matrix, we simply interchange the row and column of the given matrix. So in a given matrix A, we interchange the row and column. The new matrix obtained is called the transpose of matrix A. It is usually denoted by A dash, or sometimes it is denoted by A to the power T. This is the representation or a notation for a transpose of matrix. So let us consider a square matrix A of 3 into 3 order, and this AT represents the transpose of this 3 into 3 square matrix. So we just interchange the rows and columns. This first row becomes first column, the second row becomes second column, and the third row becomes third column. So in this manner, we find the transpose of any given square matrix or any other order of matrix. Now we discuss the some properties, some important properties of eigenvalues. So very first property is eigenvalues of a square matrix A and its transpose AT are always same. Means if we determine the eigenvalue for any given square matrix, let us consider A is suppose some 2×2 order square matrix. If we determine the eigenvalue for this 2×2 square matrix, definitely we get two values of lambda in characteristic equation lambda 1 and lambda 2. Let us consider these two, lambda 1 and lambda 2 are eigenvalues for our given square matrix A of 2×2 order. Then the transpose of AT are the same eigenvalues. And why it is so? Because as we know that if we interchange the rows and column in the determinant value remains unchanged. And that's why if we find the characteristic polynomial, and when we expand the characteristic polynomial for AT, it gives us the same characteristic equation. And because we get both for both A and AT same characteristic equation, that's why it possesses the same number of same type of eigenvalues or same characteristic roots. So therefore, eigenvalues of square matrix A and its transpose AT are always same. The second important property is the sum of the eigenvalues of a matrix is equal to the dress of the matrix. So this is a shortcut trick for finding the sum of eigenvalue without calculating eigenvalue separately. See, there is one method through which we find the sum of eigenvalue, which is the usual method in which we first of all we construct our characteristic matrix, then we determine its characteristic polynomial, and further as soon as we put characteristic polynomial is equal to 0, it gives us characteristic equation. And whatever roots of characteristic equation gives us our eigenvalues. And finally, add the eigenvalues. Whatever eigenvalues we get, we simply add them in order to determine the sum of eigenvalues of any given square matrix A. But there is a short trick for finding sum of eigenvalues. Without determining eigenvalues separately, we just directly find the sum of eigenvalues of a matrix with the help of this trick. Means the sum of eigenvalues of a matrix is equal to the dress of the matrix. So suppose we have some eigenvalue, for example, we have square matrix A 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 1 and 1, 2 and 2. This is 3×3 square matrix, right? Now, and we already discussed this is square matrix 3×3 order, but this is 3 eigenvalues which we already calculated 1, 1 and 5. This square matrix A possesses 3 eigenvalues which we already determined 1, 1 and 5. And if we add them, 1 plus 1 plus 5 gives us 7. So sum of the eigenvalues of A is 7 in this case. And if we determine the dress of this square matrix A, which is again dress of A, the sum of principal diagonal element, which is 2 plus 3 plus 2, which is 3. So from here we observe that the sum of eigenvalue coincide with the dress of square matrix A. So in order to find sum of eigenvalues, we directly find the dress of our square matrix A without finding eigenvalues through the usual method. This is the short trick to find the sum of eigenvalues of any given square matrix A. Next property, the third property, which is the product of eigenvalues of a matrix A is equal to the determinant of A. See, in second property we discussed the sum of eigenvalue, which is equal to the dress of given square matrix A. In the third property, we will observe the product of eigenvalues is always equal to the determinant value of A. Suppose we want to calculate product of eigenvalues. So we do not find the eigenvalues with the help of usual method and finally we get eigenvalues and we predict them. Instead of doing this lengthy phenomena, we just find the determinant value of A directly, and which always coincides with the product of eigenvalues, which we already done, like for square matrix A, we have 1, 1 and 5, 3 eigenvalues. In order to determine a product of eigenvalue, 1 into 1 into 5 gives us 5. And this product of 3 eigenvalue coincides with the determinant value of A, because the square matrix A, which is 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 1 and 1, 2, 2. If we determine the determinant value of this square matrix A, we find 3 to the 6 minus 2. This is 2 and minus 1 and finally 1, 2 minus 3. 6 minus 2 gives us 4. Minus 2, minus 1, finally 8, minus 2 and minus 1. See, 8, minus 2 and minus 1 gives us plus 5. So here we observe that the product of eigenvalue always coincides with the determinant value of our square matrix A. Both are identical, same. Five. In this case, we will find 1 because the product of 1 into 1 into 5 is 5 and determinant value of A is also 5. So here we observe that the product of eigenvalue is always equal to the determinant value, and while sum of eigenvalue coincides with the trace of given square matrix A. The next property is, let us consider a square matrix A of n into n order. Let us consider and A consists of n number of rows and n number of columns, then given square matrix of n order. And clearly, because A is of n into n order, so definitely it possesses n number of eigenvalues like lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, and it goes up to lambda n because it possesses n values of lambda. Then the eigenvalues of then the eigenvalues of k times of a, which is simply a scalar multiple of a, k times of a, it may be 2 times of a or 3 times of a. Suppose we have eigenvalues for any given square matrix as lambda 1 and lambda 2. Suppose these are the two eigenvalues of any given square matrix of 2 into 2 order, lambda 1 and lambda 2. Then eigenvalues for 3 times of k, this is thrice of given square matrix A. It will be quite simple to find the eigenvalues for thrice time of A because we know already the eigenvalues of A are lambda 1 and lambda 2. So the eigenvalues for thrice time of A will be thrice time of lambda 1 and thrice time of lambda 2. Simply a scalar multiple. So eigenvalues of K times of any given square matrix A is equal to the k times of eigenvalues of A, k times of lambda 1, k times of lambda 2 up to k times of lambda n. The next one is, suppose we have some eigenvalues for any given square matrix A. In order to determine eigenvalues for any inverse matrix of A, then it is quite simple, we just reciprocal all the eigenvalues of A in order to find the eigenvalues of A inverse. So if lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n are eigenvalues for a n into n square matrix A, then the eigenvalues for A inverse will be 1 upon lambda 1, 1 upon lambda 2, 1 upon lambda 3 up to 1 upon lambda n. Means simply reciprocal of whatever eigenvalues of A. This is the final one, A to the power n, because the eigenvalues lambda 1 to the power m, lambda 2 to the power m, up to lambda n to the power m, where m is any positive integer. Suppose we have eigenvalues for A and we have to find eigenvalues for A square, A cube, A raised to power 4. Then we just simply put the power on eigenvalues, whatever eigenvalues of A. Like suppose we have eigenvalues of A matrix which is which is of 2 into 2 order, as 2 and 3. Let us consider 2 and 3 are eigenvalue of any given square matrix A of 2 into 2 order. Then the eigenvalue of AQ, the eigenvalues of matrix square matrix AQ is given by 2Q and 3Q, which is 8 and 27. So we just simply put the power of whatever power of A over the eigenvalues. So lambda 1 to the power m, lambda 2 to the power m up to lambda n to the power m gives us eigenvalues for A to the power n. Okay, now finally we discuss few problems which is based on eigenvalues and characteristic equations. The very first question is find the characteristic equation of the following matrices where first matrix is of 2 into 2 order because it possesses 2 rows and 2 columns, while the second matrix possesses 3 rows and 3 columns, which is of 3 order. So first, in order to find characteristic equation, first of all we write our 2 into 2 given square matrix, which is 2, 1, minus 1 and 5. Because order of A is 2 into 2, so we consider our unit matrix and identity matrix of similar order. So we write I2, which represents a unit matrix or identity matrix of 2 into 2 order, and it is 1, 0, 0, 1, same 2 into 2 order unit matrix. And we multiply scalar quantity lambda to this identity matrix. It gives us lambda 0, 0, lambda. So for characteristic equation, first of all we determine characteristic matrix of a given square matrix A, and which is given by square bracket A minus lambda I, which is again same order, 2 into 2 order matrix. So for A we have 2, 1, minus 1 and 5. Minus for lambda I we have lambda 0, 0, lambda, and finally we subtract them. And you know how to subtract 2 into 2 order square matrices? We simply subtract the corresponding element of both the matrices, like 2 minus lambda, 1 minus 0 gives us 1, minus 1 minus 0 is 0, and 5 minus lambda. And this is our desired characteristic matrix. This is our characteristic matrix of given square matrix A. This is 2 minus lambda, 1 minus 1 and 5 minus lambda. This is, which is again 2 into 2 square matrix. This is our desired characteristic matrix of given square matrix A. After calculating a characteristic matrix of given square matrix A, we compute our characteristic polynomial, and which is determinant value of characteristic matrix, that is A determinant A minus lambda I, and which is 2 minus lambda, 1 minus 1 and 5 minus lambda. The determinant value of this, and this is because 2 into 2 order determinant, so we just simplify by cross multiplying them, 2 minus lambda multiplied with 5 minus lambda, and cross multiply minus minus become plus 1. And finally 5 to the 10 minus 2 lambda minus 5 lambda plus lambda square and plus 1. So lambda square 5 minus 5 lambda and minus 2 lambda gives us minus 7 lambda, and 8 plus 1 gives us 11. So this is our desired characteristic polynomial for a given square matrix A, and which is lambda square minus 7 lambda plus 11. As soon as we put this characteristic polynomial is equal to 0, means lambda square minus 7 lambda plus 11 equal to 0, this gives us our desired characteristic equation and for the given square matrix A. So this is quadratic in terms of lambda because order of our square matrix is 2 into 2. If order of our square matrix is 3 into 3, definitely we get a cubic equation in terms of lambda. Now we discuss the characteristic equation for second matrix, which is of 3 into 3 order, 1, 0, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, and 1. This is 3 into 3 square matrix. See, in order to determine characteristic equation for this 3 into 3 square matrix, first of all we consider a unit matrix I, which is again 3 into 3 order, because order of A is 3 into 3. So we assume our unit matrix or any identity matrix of same order, and which is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0. So this unit matrix consists of principal diagonal element as unity, that is 1, and all other remaining elements are 0. Now multiply this 3 into 3 unit matrix with the scalar quantity lambda. So then the all principal diagonal elements 1, 1, 1 become lambda. We will get lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda 0, and 0, 0, lambda. Now we determine the characteristic matrix for a 3 into 3 square matrix A, and which is A minus lambda I, 1, 0, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, and 1. And we subtract lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda 0, and 0, 0, lambda. Finally, we observe 1 minus lambda, 3 minus 0 gives us 3, 2 minus 0 gives us 2, 1 minus lambda, minus 1 minus 0, 3, minus 1, 1 minus 0, 1, minus 1 minus 0, minus 1, and 1 minus lambda. This is desired characteristic matrix for a given square matrix. For given square matrix A. This matrix A minus lambda I, which is again 3 into 3 order, and it is known as characteristic matrix for a given square matrix A. Now, in order to find its characteristic equation, first of all we find the characteristic polynomial, which is the determinant value of our characteristic matrix. So let us find determinant A minus lambda I, which is our characteristic polynomial, 1 minus lambda, 0, 3, 2, 1 minus lambda, minus 1, 1, minus 1, and 1 minus 1. So we simply replace the square bracket with the two vertical lines which represent the determinant value of our characteristic matrix for A. And finally we expand this determinant by the usual method, 1 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda multiplied with 1 minus lambda. So minus 1 gives us plus 1. But we put negative sign between them. So and 0, so whatever it is, when we multiply this with 0, it becomes vanished, and finally we put 3. When we choose 3, we hide the third column and first row. So the remaining elements are 4, 2, 1 minus lambda, 1 and minus 1. So we will just find the cross multiplication of them. 3 into minus 1 gives us minus 2, and minus 4 plus minus 1. Finally, we simplify this determinant expansion. And 1 minus lambda whole square minus 1. Minus 1 minus 1 gives minus of 3 plus lambda. Finally, 1 minus twice of lambda plus lambda square minus 1. Minus of 9 and plus 3 lambda. Finally, we cancel out 1 and minus 1, so remaining is minus 2 lambda plus lambda square and 3 lambda minus 1. So we just multiply 1 into minus 2 lambda plus lambda square, and then minus lambda, so gives us 2 lambda square and minus of lambda cube plus 3 lambda minus 1. So finally, minus of lambda cube, 2 lambda square and 1 lambda square gives us 3 lambda square, and 3 lambda and minus lambda is plus lambda and minus of lambda. This is the desired cubic equation in terms of lambda, and which is the desired characteristic polynomial. This is characteristic polynomial, okay? And as soon as we put this characteristic polynomial, which is minus of lambda cube minus 3 lambda square minus lambda plus 9 is equal to 0. This gives us our desired characteristic equation of this square matrix A, because we put our characteristic polynomial is equal to 0. Question number 2, if 1, 2 and 3 are the eigenvalues of a matrix A, then find the eigenvalues of A inverse and A cube, A raised to power 3, where A is this much. A is given by this 3 into 3 matrix, then we have to find A inverse and A cube. Here we use properties of eigenvalue. As we know that eigenvalues of square matrix A and its inverse, we can easily determine eigenvalues for A inverse by just putting a reciprocal of eigenvalues of A. Suppose eigenvalues, as it is given that eigenvalues for A is 1, 2 and 3, so we just reciprocal them, means instead of 1 we write 1 by 1, for 2 we write 1 by 2 and for 3 we have 1 by 3. Because 1, 2, 3 are eigenvalues of A, so eigenvalues for A inverse will be 1 upon 1, 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3. Whatever eigenvalues of A, we put them in an inverse form or a reciprocal form in order to find the eigenvalue of A inverse. And according to the property of eigenvalues, for eigenvalues for A cube will be 1 cube, 2 cube and 3 cube. As we know that eigenvalue of A to the power m is given by eigenvalue to the power m, lambda 1 to the power m, lambda 2 to the power m, and so on. So in our case, we have m equal to 3. So whatever eigenvalues of A, 1, 2, 3, we just put the power 3 over the all the eigenvalues. So 1 cube gives us 1, 2 cube gives us 8, and 3 cube gives us 27. So 1, 8 and 27 are the eigenvalues for this A cube. Question number 3, find the sum and product of eigenvalues of matrix A. See, as we know that the sum of eigenvalues is always coincide with the dress of given square matrix A, and product of eigenvalue is equivalent to the determinant value of A. So by using these two properties, we can easily find the sum and product without determining eigenvalue separately by a traditional method in which we first of all find its characteristic matrix, then characteristic polynomial, and finally characteristic equation. And we find the roots of characteristic equation, which gives us an eigenvalue. It's a very lengthy phenomena. Using that method, we find all three eigenvalues for this square matrix A, and we add them and product them. There's a short trick through which we can easily find the sum and product of eigenvalues. So here, the sum of eigenvalues is equal to the trace of A, as we know, is equal to the sum of, and trace of A means the sum of principal diagonal elements. So in our case, our principal diagonal elements are simply 2, 4 and 2. So 2 plus 4 plus 2 gives us 8. And this is sum of eigenvalues. And for product of eigenvalue, we determine the determinant value of A. Here, our square matrix A is 2, 1, minus 1, 3, 4, 2, and 1, 0, 2. So we find the determinant value of 2, 1, minus 1, 3, 4, 2, and 1, 0, 2. So just cross multiply them, 4 into 2, 8, 3 into 2, 6, minus 2, and finally 0 minus 4. 8 to the 16, 6 minus 2 gives us 4, 4 minus 4 minus 8 plus 4, and finally we get 16. So the product of eigenvalues given by determinant value of A, and which we obtain 16. So sum of eigenvalues given by A and product of eigenvalues are given by 16. The next question, find the eigenvalues of a square matrix A. And here we observe that this square matrix is basically a upper triangular matrix. Upper triangular matrix whose principal diagonal, below the principal diagonal element, all elements are 0. And in order to find the eigenvalues of this square matrix A, we find its characteristic polynomial, which is determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. Which is 2 minus lambda 4, 7, 0, 1 minus lambda 8, 0, 0, and 3 minus 1. And as soon as we put our characteristic polynomial equal to 0, it gives us our desired characteristic equation, and it gives us 2 minus lambda, 1 minus lambda, and 3 minus lambda is equal to 0. And finally, we get 1, 2, and 3 as a desired eigenvalue to this square matrix A of 3 to 3 order. Thank you.